In this video, we'll learn about contour matching and see how we can use it for checking similarities between two images. So let's begin. So in this example, we have three images. So first we'll compare these two images of tigers and check the similarity score of their contours. And then we'll compare one of the images of tigers with that of a gorilla and check the similarity. And we'll see that the difference between these two images will be lesser, as these two images are similar, even though if it is not exactly same, because you can see the image on the left is a little bit zoomed and the tiger is facing this side, and this image is a translated version of this image, and also the scale is lesser compared to this image and the tiger is facing in this direction. So let's see the code. So the first thing that we'll do is we'll import the libraries. We'll import cv2 and matplotlib. Now here we'll define a function which will read the image, convert it into grayscale and then into a binary image so that we can get its contour later on. Let image be its parameter. Now we'll read the image, so img equals to cv2.imread, then we'll convert it into a grayscale image, so cv2.cvt color img cv2.color bgr. Binary image, we'll be using cv2's threshold function, so cv2.threshold gray img will be the image, and we'll be converting all the pixel values between 50 and 255 into white. We'll be using a thread binary inverse method. And it returns two values, so we'll be using the second value, as second value contains the image. So we'll be inverting it because in our image, if you see the main region of interest is black in color, and if you want to draw a contour, so we need to have our main region of interest in white color, so hence we'll be inverting the threshold. After that, we'll be displaying it. We'll be using CMAP, as this will be a grayscale image. And then we'll return the binary image so that we can use it further. Now in the next step, we'll pass our input images to the above function. Let's name it binary img1 is equals to bin img. The name of our first image is tiger1.jpg. So you can see our image over here. Here you can use any threshold value according to your requirement. And also you can notice that our region of interest is now white in color, whereas in the original image it was black in color. Now similarly, we read the second image. So this is our second image. Now in the next step, we'll find the contours of the images. Contour, let's name it contour1, comma hierarchy is equal to cv2.find contours binary image 1. Now you want only the external contours. We'll write cv2.retr external . The next parameter is approximation method of contour. So here we'll write chain approx simple. Okay, for contour matching. Now similarly we'll find contour for a second image. Next, finally, we'll find difference between the two contours. Let contif be the value of difference between the two contours. Here we'll be using cv2.matchshapes method. The first two arguments will be the contour or the images. So here our contour is in the form of a list. And since there is only one contour present in our image, so we'll be using the 0th index. Similarly, here we'll write contour 2 and the 0th index. Third argument is a compare method, which are basically three different mathematical formulas for calculating the difference between the two contours, and all the three methods use U moments for calculation. So you can write cv2.contours match i1 or i2 or i3. There are three methods actually, or instead of this you can also write 1, 1 or 2 or 3 in place of writing this. So for example, if I want to write this in place of this, I can write 1 as well. And similarly, if I want to write i2, so in place of it, I can write 2 as well. So it will mean the same. And the fourth argument is a parameter which is related to the compare method. So we usually keep it as 0. Now U moments which are used by the compare method are 7 values which describes a contour shape. The first 6 values remain unchanged even if an image is scaled or rotated, translated or reflected. And the 7th value changes its sign if the image is reflected. Now the U moments calculated for an image or a contour will be more accurate if the resolution of that image is very high, whereas it will be lesser accurate if the image is a little bit pixelated. So without further ado, let's just print the value. So you can see that the value is pretty much close to 0, although it is not exactly 0. And the reason is, like I said earlier, for lower resolution images, the output may not be perfect. Now similarly, we'll compare a tiger's image with that of gorilla. That is this image with this image. So here I've already copied a piece of code. Here we read the gorilla's image and pass it to this function and then find its contour. Next, we'll compare the first contour with our third contour, which is gorilla. This one is of tiger, and let's see the output. Here you can see the output is nearly 2 magnitudes greater than our first output. And it makes sense because this image is not same as that of the first image. So higher the value, more the different the images or the contours are, and more a value is nearer to zero, more similar the images or the contours are. So I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.